Oh, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Brittany, aka Truth Speaking, aka Truth Speaking. Anyways,
stop what you doing, think before you speak on me, boy.
I made this video already, but when I made it, I was like really, really sad, and you could just tell in the video that I was just not in the best of headspace, and it just, I didn't like the video, basically. But please excuse my lips. I tried to wear some lipstick for y'all today, but the shit was just not working. I had on a purple. I tried to take it off because it looked a hot mess. And it just was, now my lips are pink. I tried to scrub it off, it's not coming off. So the best I could do was put some lip gloss on top of it and call it a day. You feel me? And my eyebrows are bushy as fuck. I didn't have time. I couldn't go to the nail shop, salon, whatever, you know, where you get your eyebrows waxed at. I didn't have time because I was at work all day. And my makeup, without all that further ado, we're finna get into the video. This video is about your 20, your 20 somethings, okay? Like 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, all the way up to 29, okay? Cause I've just been stressed. Like I've seriously been stressed. My birthday was July 10th, which was, I don't, like what, two Mondays ago? I guess, I don't know, because today is July 19th, so about 2 Mondays ago was my turn 24, so shout out to all my Cancers. You know, we're the most loving, we're the most caring, we're just the best sign there is, and say, and we can argue, if you want to argue, we can argue. Anyways, I turned 24, and I have never felt so lost, seriously. I'm just lost. Like, I don't know what direction I'm supposed to be going with my life, you know. I see my friends and people I'm cool with, you know, having babies, getting married, moving in together, you know, all this kind of shit, and I'm just sitting here like, hello, what about me, you know, so that's really been like, and I know I can't like base my life off of other people's lives, you know, because, you know, maybe it's their time, it's just not my time right now, and, you know, God's not giving it to me because he knows that I'm not ready for that right now, or my life is just everywhere that if he was to give it to me right now, the shit would probably crumble, you feel me? So when I was at work, I was talking to my cousin, Dante, and I was telling him how I felt, and like I feel like I never go through with like all my goals, and I never complete any of my goals. I never stick with it, like I'm always falling off. And so he told me that I should fast, or if y'all don't know what fasting is, fasting, you know, it's, I don't know, I don't believe it's just for Christians, but I think they call it different things for, you know, different religions, but for Christians is fasting, like you give up something you feel like you're addicted to, whether it be alcohol or, you know, social media or like food. Some people fast from food, like sweets or soda, you know, you can, whatever you feel like you're addicted to, that's what you fast from. So I feel like I was addicted to Facebook. Like I would go to sleep on Facebook, I would wake up on Facebook, I would, like, you know, just, I was constantly on Facebook. Like every chance I could get, I would get on Facebook or Snapchat. So I decided to delete my Facebook app. So I have not been on Facebook for about a good 2 weeks now, which surprisingly, I haven't even been worried about it, honestly. Like I can see how people get depressed, like from social media, because I'll get on Instagram and I'll see all of these girls, you know, like perfect bodies, they got, you know, they're making all this money and they're going out doing, you know, whatever, and here I am struggling, you feel me, like to try and just pay, you know, the little bills that I do have. And it's bitches out here traveling and shit my age. And I'm like, you know, but then I be like, okay, well, we all got the same 24 hours, you feel me? What they doing their 24 hours, I might not doing my 24 hours, you know? You know, they probably out there grinding and I'm over here asleep. You feel me? Like, they doing everything they gotta do and I'm bullshitting basically. Cause I get off of work at 5 o'clock, okay? Instead of me going to the gym, like I said I was, I would come home and literally get in the bed and I'll stay on social media. I'll go from Facebook to Snapchat to Instagram, back to Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, whatever. Back and forth through all them apps. By the time you know it, when I look at the time, it's damn near 10 o'clock and I ain't do shit but lay in the bed the whole rest of the day when I could have at least went to the gym for an hour and then came home and did whatever, you know? So, mind you, I'm telling my cousin all this as well. The same stuff that I'm saying, I was telling my cousin. So when he told me, you know, because I can't base my life off of other people's life, you know, it's their time, it's not my time. I can't base my life off of my friends' lives with them having babies. And when my cousin told me that I should fast from social media, I was like, you know what? That might be the best thing for me right now because watching other people live their lives, I'm not living my life. So he said, while I'm fasting, I should read. So I started reading this book that I remember I had went and got from Barnes & Noble. I took the thing off of it, but it's called Change Your Thinking, Change Your Life. And y'all, this book is the shit. Literally, I've been reading it. Well, I started over. And like, I literally will sit here and like underline, you know, stuff or whatever. Like, this is a really good book. So, and it was only $8, you know, like, you know, write down your goals. So I also did that in this little note chart thing. I wrote my goals down. Now, mind you, okay, I've always had goals. I just never written them down for me to like physically see them, you know. Like, if you don't have no, like, I've had goals, I just never have written them down like that. But I feel like if you don't have goals at all, it's like, sis, what are you doing? Like, what are you working towards? What are you trying to get out of, like, you know, what are you trying to accomplish if you don't have goals for yourself, whether it be weight loss like mine or staying consistent with YouTube or going to church, you know? Like, those are my main things. But this, like, saving money, I need to save money, or if I'm not, I need to use my money to invest in, you know, because I really want to do YouTube, so I can use my money to invest in like a camera or a laptop or you know, like, I just went and bought this, you know, my lights or whatever, everything. In order for me to come up in my channel, you know, I need to put like my money towards it if that's what I really want to do, you know. So those are some of my goals. I also have a journal that I just write in, like, that I write in, and it's just this little heart journal I got from I got this from Target, like in the $5 section or whatever. But it has like kind of like chapters or whatever. So look, y'all, I write like everything. I put these little sticky notes, like, it's little sticky notes in here. These got quotes and stuff on them or whatever, like, you know, quotes I seen off of like Pinterest or Instagram, or, you know, just quotes that I like or little statements or whatever. And then, you know, I write. This also helps with, like, you know, if I feel like I can't really talk to nobody like that about what I'm going through or how I really feel, like, if nobody was to understand me, I just write in my journal, and that really helps too, you know. So I do all those things, staying off of social media and all that. And honestly, from my last video, I could tell a big difference. Like, I'm chilling, like, and this weekend I think I'm going do stuff with some of my friends or whatever. So I'm also going to have a vlog up, you know. So I just feel like I'm happy that I'm in a happy place right now. I'm doing what I said I wanted to do. And at this point, it's like, if you're not with me, if you're not helping me, if you're not trying to push me to get to what I want, then I don't need you around me, you know. I'm really proud of myself. I feel good. Like, with going to the gym, I feel better, like, about myself, period, because I really feel like I'm working towards my goals. Like, I'm not just saying it anymore. I'm actually putting actions to it, you know. And that's another thing I think God wanted me to do. Like, I talk about it all day. I talk about losing weight. You could talk about it all day, but if you're not doing actions to get to where you want to go, you know, how you expect somebody to help you and you not even doing your part? Like, you know, that's basically what I was doing. I'm telling everybody I want this, this, and that, and I'm not doing shit. Like, come on, sis, get it together. You feel me? Like, I'm thankful for all the people that watch me, even if it's just a little bit. But I know, like, if I be consistent, like I'm planning to be, everything is gonna get better. Everything gets better with time, you know. I know that when I turn 25, I cannot be in this same spot that I am right now, because that means I haven't grown. That means I have what have I done? If I'm still gonna be in the same spot when I'm 25, what really have I accomplished? You know, then I really feel bad, because that's how I felt when I turned 24. Like, I'm 24, and what do I have to show for it? My car isn't even in. Well, you know, I'm thankful for everything that I have, but like, what do I have for it? My car will be paid off this year. It's not even really mine yet, you know. Like, I'm planning to move out. I want to move out, even though I don't have to. Like, I don't pay anything. They're not making me, you know, whatever. It's just, I feel like when I turn 25, it's about that time for me to be on my own. You know, I just want my own space. Like, that's just what I want. I don't know if y'all know who SZA is. I know a lot of the females do, but if y'all know who SZA is, SZA, look up her song called 20 something. That shit is real as fuck. Like, you're 20 somethings because you feel like you're like in the middle. Like, you're too young to have it all together, but then again, at the same time, you're too old not to have it together, you know. Like, when I was young, I said I wanted to be married by 25. Bitch, what? Married to who? Bitch, I sleep alone. I don't sleep alone. But you get what I'm saying. Like, I'm not going to be married by the time I'm 25. You know, unless God mysteriously, miraculously, which he can do it. He can. Somebody show up, you know, and just do that for me. Like, you know. I have somebody right now that's trying to do that for me, you know, but I just want to make sure, like, I'm okay within myself, you know. I can't be any good for anybody else if I'm not good within myself, you know. But he does encourage me, he pushes me to do YouTube, like, you know, he encourages me to do all that, and I really do appreciate that. Like, anything I want to do, he'd be like, you can do it, you know. And that's the type of person I need around me. I don't on the phone. Or my cousin too. She'll call me and we'll talk on the phone while she at the gym and I'm at the gym, you know. But she lives in Washington. If y'all didn't know, I'm from Washington. I was born and raised in Washington. And then we moved to Texas, where we stay now, when I was going to the 9th grade. So I started 9th grade in Texas. But other than that, I'm from Washington. Anyways, that's a whole nother story. So she'll call me, you know, talk to me, and we'll encourage each other to go to the gym, even though we're not even around each other, you know. And if you're looking at people on Instagram and how they, like, you know, all that they having or whatever, you can have it too. While we sitting on Instagram looking at other people and other bitches having fine-ass bodies and, you know, living the life and shit, drinking mimosas on the fucking Bahamas or Puerto Rico or Cancun, you know, while we're sitting here watching them, they're working. Think about that. You feel me? While I'm laying there watching them or looking on YouTube and looking at other people live their life, bitch, I could be living my life. But yet I'm here watching you live yours. Think about that. That's some fucked up shit. some fucked up shit. But we gonna get it together. I'm gonna end this video because I'm not. I will see you guys next time. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to subscribe to me, and I'll be back with more videos. Bye.
Stop what you doing, think, but you speak on me, boy.
Y'all wanna see the kids that be talking in the background where y'all can't hear shit? Come here. Come over here.
It's ready.
I know.
I'm your pinkies.
Oh, thank you. Come. Wait, what are you doing? Come here.
Handsome.
You're so handsome.
I'm your baby.
You're so pretty. This is DJ. What's your name?
DJ.
What's your name?
Deanna.
Y'all, please.
Deanna.
Yes, her name is Deanna.
Deanna.
Yes, her name
Deanna,
is.
Deanna.
He did not hit you, and you broke your glasses.
They boo.
Y'all hear kids in the background. This is who. Okay, you broke it. This is who it be. Y'all, he three, she two.
That's mine.
And they do this all day.
Mine. You take mine.
Why are you being so mean? Give it to him.